We are now living on a planet that is heated 1.2 degrees. The winds are stronger. The rains are more. The summer is longer. The waves are higher. There's coastal erosion. We're losing a way of life. We're losing a community. We are losing a country.
In 50 years, two of the Pacific countries will disappear. If two of our countries can disappear in 1.2 or 1.3, we really don't want to get to 1.5. We may not necessarily be there in not too long into the future.
Between 2016 and 2021, in this short period, we have had 13 extreme weather events. Three of them have been the worst on record. And only one of them, a cyclone Winston, would have been equivalent of taking away £900 billion from the UK economy in a couple of hours. All of them put together would have wiped away the UK economy of £2.7 trillion, I believe, twice over in a period of five years. And the cruelty of all of this is that we are expected to take that on our chin and recover from that, and that's why we are here.
One of the biggest first indication or result of climate change, I think, in the next few years, will be country after country going into default. We are already spending 30% of our budget on adaptation. We have having to build embankments, having to build water breakers, having to desalinate water. We took the loans to build a road, to build a bridge, to build a house, to build a school. Bad weather is upon us, and the house is falling down. The bridge is getting washed away. And we need adaptation to save the bridge, to save the house.
Excellencies, yesterday marked the start of cyclone season in the South Pacific.
We've been talking about what is the scale of finances that is needed for adaptation, volume of and the pace of financing that is needed.
That can erase years of infrastructure progress in a matter of hours.
We have a sufficient level of consensus that $750 billion is about the right level.
The world is warming. The impacts are terrifying. And the standard we build must be defined by and ready for those intensifying risks.
A finance minister, a country should have some sense of predictability that, you know, in next year's budget I will be able to relocate five communities. In year three's budget I will be able to rebuild five bridges so those communities can be reconnected to the towns. In year three I will be able to move two or three hospitals to higher ground. We do not have that predictability. Right now, climate finance, the cruelty of climate finance is that for countries like ours, it is like a lottery. Proof of the pudding is always in the eating, and it is what happens after COP is over, and how these votes and commitments translate into sustained climate actions, predictable climate actions in countries on the front lines.